you. So the story is about a young seagull who is at the stage of life where he has to learn to fly. His younger brothers and sisters, they have already learned, but he is still too afraid to fly. And that is why when all of them started practicing, what is he doing? He's sitting at the edge of the brink and looking at them. And why he is not ready to fly? We all know, because he could not trust his wings. He was so much terrified by the vast sea, the expanse of the sea. And he has that feeling that if he will start flying, he will fall down and he will die perhaps. But it is so, you know, pathetic to see for him actually, that he is elder, but still he has not managed to take his first flight. Whereas his own siblings, they are flying easily, even though their wings are shorter. But still it is difficult for him to muster up the courage, to summon the courage and to take the first flight. Although he was scolded by his parents for not trying again, but he was so afraid that he could not fly and he is not taking this risk. Now he had been alone for a day, as you saw that for 24 hours he was alone. He tried because his parents were busy focusing on his younger brothers and sisters. They were helping his siblings to master the art of flying, diving for food, skimming. And, you know, his sibling even caught his first fish, which he proudly ate at a rock. And his parents, they celebrated. You remember, they started cackling around him, laughing around him. And he was watching everything quite. He was actually very sad. But again, even though his mother want him to come out and to fly, but he's so scared of his short wings that he did not have faith in himself. Okay? And the same is. Now the sun had now risen and he was feeling the heat more than ever. Why? Because he was empty stomach. For last 24 hours, he hasn't eaten anything. Because till now, his mother and father was providing him food. But now they want parents. I told you that role of parenting. Now the parents want him to learn and to do the, you know, to skim, to fly, and to find out his own portion of food. So he stepped out of his ledge and pretended to sleep on one leg to gain the attention of his family. He thought that mothers, they are quite, you know, compassionate. And if mother will see, father is ek minute ke liye rude ho jayenge, siblings ho jayenge. But he was knowing that, so he decided to emotionally blackmail his mother. And what did he do? That he pretend to be falling asleep, that he has become so weak because he hadn't got the food. And he thought that his mother will look at him and maybe she will offer him some food. Still, they took no notice of him. But as if the entire family or maybe parents, they have decided something. Maybe this is a plan. He saw his two brothers and his sister laying on the plateau, dozing with their heads sunk into their necks. His father was preening, making an effort to maintain feathers, washing, cleaning the feather. The feathers on his white back. Only his mother was looking at him. Mother, I told you, they are so soft-hearted, so compassionate that although she wanted that this should be done to him. Otherwise, he will never realize the importance of flying. And he is a bird. He has to learn this skill. So, but still she was looking at him. She was standing on a little high hump on the plateau, her white breast thrust forward. Now and again, she tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet and then scraped each side of her beak on the rock. The sight of the food maddened him. Okay, so now what was he? Nobody was noticing him. Siblings were sleeping, father was cleaning his feather and his beak, and his mother was standing on another plateau eating fish. and she was also noticing him. And our seagull, he got mad because he was hungry, extremely hungry. For last 24 hours, he hasn't had anything. So the sight of food maddened him. The seagull got, you know, mad on seeing the fish because he was actually very hungry. He wanted to have that food at any cost, but no one was there to help him. Okay, so no, Sonu, camera off kar lo beta, no need to show your face. Okay, so he loved to tear away fish and scrape his beak now and then. So he want that he should also get that piece of food, that fish, and he loved to, you know, scrap his beak now and again to eat that food. Scrapping means discarding. So in this manner, mother was watching everything. Mother was knowing that how badly he needed food. But no, she decided not to give him anything because she want her, this seagull, to learn this skill. How long? I told you that we have, our parents are there to look after us. But they too have limitation. After some day or maybe after some year, they will also give you wings. Wings here means symbolically that education. Okay, and they will ask you to go and earn, go and live on your own. So this is the role of parents because they cannot keep you all the time under their own shelter. So mother also said, okay, he was watching and observing everything. And she was knowing that my son is hungry. She also wanted to feed him. But if this time she will become weak, what will happen? This bird will never learn this skill. So she has to be hard. I told you yesterday also that why parents sometimes they punish you or maybe they pretend to be hard-hearted just because they wanted to you to learn something which is going to benefit you for your life. And then he said, ga, ga, ga. He cried, begging her to bring him some food. Shayad apne language mein bola hoga, mama, I'm hungry, give me food. And he begged, okay, mama, give me food. But mama, ga cola. She screamed back derisively. But mama also in her own language, she should have scolded him. Go to hell. I don't want to feed you. You lazy. Basically he was what he was scared. So maybe she would have screamed. She screamed back derisively. Means something that it is very stupid. That why you are asking for the food. Expressing her contempt, expressing her, you know, ridiculing him, mazak udate hue ki, come on, don't listen, I'm not going to give you food. But he kept calling plaintively. Plaintively means sadly, ekdam rote hue. And after a minute or so, he uttered a joyful scream. Now, obviously, seagull was hungry. Mother was watching him. He was asking now and again, come, please, mama, give me some food. But mother was also yelling, and she was actually trying to ridicule him, making fun of him, ki no. But all of a sudden, what happened? He kept on calling. He was calling for last so many minutes, come on, give me something. Maybe he was crying because now it is difficult, unbearable for him to, you know, without food, to go without food. So this pain was unbearable. Okay, this hunger was unbearable for him. So he was crying continuously. And all of a sudden, his plaintive cry, that means sad, monotonous, that cry, also changed into a joyful scream. Means he started screaming happily. Achanak, dukh se khushi ho gaya. Kya hua? What happened? What did he see? Maybe mother? She had a pity on her son and she decided to feed him. Something had happened. That's why all of a sudden his tone changed. His mother had picked up a piece of the fish and was flying across to him with it. Yes, he saw that finally mother, she picked a piece of fish and now she is coming to him. He leaned out eagerly, tapping the rope. You can see in the picture with his feet. Okay, this is the trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. Okay, so till now everything was going on according to his wish. He was excited because he saw, all of a sudden he became happy. Why? Because he saw that mother is coming towards him. What with a piece of fish? So maybe she will be able to feed him, because after all, she is a mother. She cannot remain so hard-hearted for the longer hours. She has to feed her baby. And so he thought ki finally mama ko to pyar aa gaya. And that's why she is coming to him and bringing that piece of fish. And he came to the edge, tapping the rock with his feet, trying to get nearer to her as he flew across. So he decided, he got excited and he thought that now she is coming nearer. And so he started leaning forward. But yahan pe story mein ek change aaya. Mother is also very smart. There is a twist in the story. What did she do? No. Yeah, she has come with that piece of fish. And she decided, lekin plan mein change aa gaya. Kya tha woh? But when she was just opposite to him, she halted, her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. Imagine karo, you would have seen this scene in the movies, okay? Usi tarah ka kuch hua. That she came near, he also leaned forward. Suddenly, she stopped in the air, okay? Not very far from him. And then what did you do? They both were very close. He thought that you would have seen how the birds feed their baby bird. He also thought that my mother will put that piece of fish in my beak and all will be well. But, aisa kuch nahi hua. It didn't happen. He waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer. And he was waiting. Why? She is here. She is there with very close to me, but why she is not coming closer to me? Although I have been hungry for last 24 hours, she is my mother, she knows it very well. But she stopped in the air. She kept on hovering in the air. And then he dived at the fish. He was so hungry. He didn't think, what is he going to do? He didn't even think that his wings are so small. It will not help and support him while flying. And he dived at the fish. Achanak usne ek dive liya. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into the space. And then a monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. So what happened? He kept on, he waited for the food. But when he knew that his mother will not give him that food, he took a dive. What did he do? He saw that very nicely he dived at the fish without realizing for a moment that he was afraid, he was scared to fly. And he got so excited that he started feeling upward, downward into that space. And then all of a sudden what happened? A monstrous means huge, horrible, big, a monstrous that terror seized him. Because now all of a sudden he realized, for a moment he was in shock. And what happened? Because he always used to think that this is very difficult for him, rather impossible for him to fly. And so now he realized that, okay, just because that food, I took this, tremendous leap. And what happened? That monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still for a moment. His heart was going away. He felt that he will die. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a minute. So for a moment, everything was still. He cannot listen anything. He was so scared of this flying. But then it only lasted a minute. The next moment he felt his wings spread outwards. The wind rushed against his breast feathers, then under his stomach and against his wings. He could fly, the tips of his wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. Headlong means sir ke bal aise nahi gira tha. He was soaring gradually downward and upward. You would have seen soaring in the air. Urata flying, he was no longer afraid. What does it mean? That means he was actually scared of taking first flight. Ye dekho, bhaiya, symbolically kya kehna cha raha hai? As a whenever you will take up new challenge in your life, anything new, okay, regarding your education, your profession, your anything, then definitely you too will be scared of it. Maybe you will be scared of the consequences. You will be scared of the hardships. You will be scared of the adversities. You will be scared of the challenges. But if there is no other way left for you, then what will you do? You will take up that as a challenge. Dar se ya bina dare. But you will definitely take that as a challenge. And once you will start working on it, then what will happen? Things will become easier. Gradually, things will become easier, and you too will learn the skill that how you will overcome those challenges of life. Yahi wo kehna chah raha hai ki once he took the first flight, dekho, till now what he was been thinking, that how my parents are so, you know, cruel, and why they are not actually, why my mother is being so harsh, why she is not giving me food, although she knew it very well that I'm hungry. But now he will realize that why his mother was so rude, why his mother did not want him to give food, because she want. Okay, Siddharth. Okay. So why this was not happening? Am I audible, children? Raise your hand. Okay. So Siddharth, just I think the problem is from your side. Okay. Problem is from your side. Siddharth, फिर से join कर लो बेटा. So basically what happened, that is the basic purpose of writing this story. यही ये basic purpose है कि कोई भी नया काम या नया skill, you know, you will be scared of it. But once you start it, everything will be easy. You remember, tumhe yaad nahi bhi hoga, but you can talk to your parents that when you're for the very first time you were admitted to school and you have to leave the safe and secure place, your home, and you have to come to a disciplined world. Yaad hai na? That was so scary. Thereafter you started doing the things on your own. Aur abhi life will pose so many challenges. Bahut sare challenges aayenge. Khud se akele rehna, job karna, so many things will be there. So many things will be there in your life which will actually create a lot of terror in your heart. Sometimes you will feel that your parents are not helping you. But no, my dear children, that is not that. Because your parents want you to learn the new, whatever challenge life will pose before you. Okay? Kehte na, apne problems ko khud solve karna hoga tumhe. And gradually you will learn everything. So, yahi yahan pe message hona cha raha hai. This is not the story of a bird. Because ye bird ki story nahi hai. When this stage of your life, in standard 10, they are not going to teach you the story. Some Panchatantra stories are not going on. That how the seagull started flying. Symbolically, this story has a lot of meaning. You can just correlate yourself with the circumstances. You can also see the role of parents in your life. Okay? So that is why that happened. So once he took the first flight, what happened? For a moment, he was scared. He thought he will die. But thereafter, everything became well. Because wings were there, and he started flapping his wings, cutting through the air. Okay? He was not falling headlong. He was simply soaring gradually, sometimes downwards, sometimes outwards. And you know, he was no longer afraid. That is the most important thing, that he was no longer afraid. So once you accept the problems, you know, challenges of life, you will not be scared. Rather, you will know how to fight. He just felt a bit dizzy. Dizzy thoda to hoga for the very first time he is flying. So his head started spinning. Obviously, then he flapped his wings once and he soared upward. But again, he flapped, and rather he was actually enjoying that very moment. Ga, 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 kolha. His mother swooped past him, her wings making a loud wing. That means, unke language mein usne kaha, well done, my dear child. I'm so proud of you. Kya bolenge? Maluk to yehi bolegi. So basically, the mother started appreciating him in her own language, and then swooped. Swooped means moving rapidly downwards through the air. And she started moving rapidly past him, appreciating him, cheering him. Okay, her wings making a loud noise. He answered her with another scream. Obviously, she praised him and he also answered, "Thank you, Mama. I'm so happy. I learned it. Fine." Then his father flew over him screaming. Father also saw, "Oh, wow, what happened?" So the rather entire family was happy. The father was also very happy because he also wanted his son to learn this skill, because this is an essential skill of a bird. By bird, aur aapko udna nahi aayega, then what is the use of being a bird? So the father also came here. There he also started screaming, yelling in happiness. He saw his two brothers and his sister flying around him, curvetting and banking and soaring and diving. That means curvetting, leaping like horse in the air. Okay, banking, they were soaring, diving. These are the different types, performing a series of jumps on the, you know, legs. So they all were happy through their physical, you know, through their gestures, through yelling, shrieking. They all were trying to cheer him up, rather applauding him, you know, appreciating him, motivating him. They all, yahi family hoti hai na. आपको हेल्प करेगी, मोटिवेट करेगी, कभी डांटेगी भी. ऑब्वियसली पेरेंट्स विल स्कोल्ड यू, डिसिप्लिन यू, मे बी दे विल पनिश यू, बट वंस यू विल लर्न द न्यू स्किल एंड यू विल हैव दैट कॉन्फिडेंस इन योरसेल्फ, द एंटायर फैमिली इज गोइंग टू प्रेज यू, दे विल डेफिनेटली बी प्राउड ऑफ यू. समझ रहे हो ना सिम्बॉलिकली स्टोरी कैसे जा रहा है, कि जैसे तुम भी अपने लाइफ में प्रॉब्लम्स को, सॉरी न्यू चीज को सीखोगे, न्यू स्किल, देन डेफिनेटली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल योर पेरेंट्स विल एक्चुअली, नाउ डेज दे माइट बी टेलिंग यू बेटा स्टडी एंड वर्क हार्ड, पढ़ाई बहुत जरूरी है. सो मे बी समटाइम्स दे माइट बी शोइंग देयर एंगर, बट वाई दे ऑल आर डूइंग दीज थिंग्स, बिकॉज दे वॉन्टेड यू टू लर्न the you know hardships of life, and once you will go through it, then once you will learn this skill, they all are going to praise you and be happy. So the entire family is now celebrating the moment. Then he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly, and commended himself to dive and soar and curve and shrieking shrilly. Okay, so now he realized, he has forgotten that this is his first flight. Once he started flying, he forgot that this is his first flight. And then he did started doing all sorts of things, whatever other birds, his siblings, his father and mother, they were doing. He also started diving, soaring, curving, and also shrieking shrilly. Yes, shrieking shrilly. That means he started yelling happily, wanted to show the world that, yes, I did this. See, this is the new skill which I have learned. So the entire family, who were simply flying with one wing higher, other, maybe taking different type of curvetting, you know, leaping like horse, he too started doing everything. Although it was only his first flight. So basically he was having, only he needed to work on it. Only he needed to have confidence. And that confidence, from where did he receive this confidence? Obviously, when his father and mother decided to teach him a lesson. His parent, so now he was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. He saw a vast green sea beneath him, with little ridges moving over it, and he turned his beak sideways and cawed amusedly. Now, next skill, what he has to learn? One skill he has learned, and that was flying, okay, skimming, and also, you know, banking, soaring, diving, everything. But now he has to learn next skill, okay, and what was that? How to catch fish. That is also very important. So once he has overcome his fear, he forgot that he was genuinely once afraid of him. He did all those things, whatever he had seen other, you know, birds doing. And his flight straight over the sea, and he can also see the greenery and the mountain beneath him. He screamed out of joy, because obviously, he was enjoying this moment very much. you know, he cawed, C-A-W-E-D, utter a caw, that means crying away. And so he was really very happy that how he has finally overcome this. He was also happy to see the vast green sea beneath him. Earlier, previously, that sea was actually scaring him, because that vast expanse of sea, ocean was scaring him, but now he was not. So he has come with little ridges moving over a long narrow hilltop mountain range. That also he saw. So he saw mountains, he saw vast ocean, and he was really very happy to see these things and enjoy every moment of it. His parents and his brothers and sister had landed on this green flooring ahead of him. Green flooring, you know, that, you know, basically you can simply say moss or seaweeds actually, sea plantation you would have seen. So his parents and his brothers, they have landed very nicely, very safely on that green flooring. They were beckoning to him, calling shrilly. Now beckoning means gesturing, show up. Jaise hum beckon karte na, ungli se ishara karke. So through their gesture, sar hilake, however the birds are, they might be doing. So they were beckoning to him, calling shrilly. They were also calling him with a shrill voice that, come on, come and sit with us. This is the place. Now we are going to teach you another skill. He dropped his legs to stand on the green sea. But you know, this green sea, what happened? This is not very strong, not very hard. So you two have to, they have to, actually this is again a new technique which he has to learn. So he dropped his legs to stand on the green sea, because it is flowing water, sea water, ocean water, so still water hota nahi hai, wo flow karta rehta hai. So when these seaweed, yeah, jo plantation hote hai, they also keep on moving. So you have to, you know, stand very strongly on it. And then what happened? His legs sank into it. So while he was trying to stand on it smartly, then what happened? That his legs started sinking in it. And, you know, because this was the sea, and for a moment he was actually again scared. He screamed with fright and attempted to rise again, flapping his wings. So he was so much scared because that seaweed was moving. So he tried to escape, but, and he again tried to, you know, take up another flight. And, but he was tired and weak with hunger and he could not rise. But he tried to escape, but he was so tired. So not only he was tired because of flying, but he was also bad, you know, extremely hungry. So his body has also become weak. So it was difficult for him to fly again. So he was tired and weak with hunger that he could not rise, exhausted by the strange exercise. His feet sank into the green sea and then his belly touched it and he sank no further. He was floating on it and around him, his family was screaming, praising him, and other beaks were offering him scraps of dogfish. He had made his first flight. So he decided that maybe he tried escaping, but he was so tired, so weak because of hunger, because of flying, that he was not able to do that. Thus, when he calmed down, he started floating in the sea, and the same sea he was once afraid of. His family was very happy. Now he know how to hold, how to, you know, sink into the green sea with his belly touched. So he was also, and he also learned how to float on it, how to float on that green weed, that sea mosses. And as he did that, his family became so happy. They started celebrating, screaming, praising him. And not only that, they also offered him food. They were all carrying a lot of scraps of fishes in their beak, and entire family member, mother, father, brother, sister, they all started offering him a good amount of food. And why? Why they all were so happy while they were praising him? Because he had made his first flight. Finally, this bird, who was so scared of flying, he overcame his fear and he made his first flight. So one should trust one's abilities, because the fear of suffering is worse than the suffering itself. And as I have always told you, कहते नहीं है डर के आगे जीत है. तो इस जीतने के लिए तुम्हें उस डर को, यू हैव टू कॉन्कर योर फियर. एंड द सेम ही हैड डन, ही कॉन्कर्ड हिज फियर, ही स्टार्टेड फ्लाइंग. देयर आफ्टर ही वॉज नॉट स्केयर्ड विद द वास्ट एक्सपेंस ऑफ द ओशन, ही वॉज नॉट स्केयर्ड ऑफ द माउंटेन्स, ही वॉज नॉट स्केयर्ड ऑफ द यू नो फ्लोटिंग ग्रीनरी ऑफ ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ द ओशन. He was also knowing how to stand, how to hold on it. And finally, he will also learn, very soon he will learn the new skill, that how to catch fishes. And not only he will feed himself, but he will also help his parents who have always looked after him. So now this sea gull would have realized genuinely that how and why his parents, especially his mother, why she was little harsh and rude to him. Now he has realized because he देखो 24 hours की punishment उसे मिली, only 24 hours. Nobody fed him, mother also did not give him anything. And within that 24 hour, he realized that how important these kind of things are. That sometimes your parents, they are punishing you, actually that is because of, because they wanted you to learn something new, they wanted you to, you know, face the challenges of life, they wanted you to be smart. Okay, so these are the thing that through this story, this symbolical meaning the writer wants to give you.